Spring Observer program is now in its third season, and it's basically a collaboration between Save the Manatee Club, Sea to Shore Alliance, Blue Spring State Park, and Volusia County. And we have volunteers coming basically from all walks of life. We have people that are students, we have people that are full-time employed, we have people that are retired, and basically everybody is here to prevent harassment in the summertime between swimmers and manatees.
I decided to join the Manatee Observer program because I had been volunteering at Save the Manatees events, talking to people about manatees, but I wanted to get closer to them.
I wanted to be part of the Manatee Observer program because I grew up in South Florida and I always knew how important it was to protect the manatees, and knowing that there were places where people could still swim and get too close to the manatees, I felt like it was really important to do what I could do to help protect them.
We have seen an increase in manatees coming to the park in the summertime. It's usually mothers ready to give birth, or it's mothers that have just had a young calf, or manatees that have recently been released and they're still coming into the spring learning how to be a wild manatee.
Manatee Observer to Blue Springs. Just want to let y'all know that there's several manatees heading up to the boil area. I do feel like I'm making a difference, and you know, at the same time, we have a lot of people here that come from all different countries, which to me is amazing, and so I get to help educate them on the manatees, and they're just so excited about it. So I think it's fun that I can be part of the educational and plus meet all these people from different parts of the world. It's amazing.
We're going to keep these steps clear, please. We got a manatee underneath the steps. Her name is Cassie. She's 3 years old, but we need to stay 20 feet away. We just want to be respectful of her. So if you can, please use the side steps, and let's keep these clear, okay?
Many people may not know that they're not allowed to touch manatees, they're not allowed to chase them, to ride them, to get within 20 feet of manatees, to take pictures. So our volunteers are out here trying to help educate the public.
So if it comes up to you, which it may do, you just keep your hands out of the water. And if you can get to the other side of the bank, then do that too, okay? Cassie's very friendly. She won't hurt you, but you gotta be careful not to touch her.
I teach first grade over in New Smyrna Beach, and the children have been excited to learn about the manatees. I've adopted Patty Doyle. I adopted Squeaky a few years ago. And educating the children at school is one thing, but coming out here and educating the public about the manatees is a whole different thing. I've met so many people that have never seen a manatee before. They've been able to see their first manatee when I was watching and teaching them about them. And they have a newfound passion for this creature as well. And so coming out into the environment, which I love to be in, and educating people out here makes a huge difference in my life. And I hope it's making a difference in theirs too.
You guys, the manatee's coming down. So if you could just stay to the side. She's coming down the center.
Okay. I want public to know and appreciate our species, our nature, the park itself, but they have to also understand that there's boundaries and rules, just like anything else, just like driving a car. It's, you know, an opportunity to enjoy nature, but at the same time, we're educating them, letting them know what the reasons are.
Some of the challenges of the Manatee Observer program are handling the large amount of visitors here at Blue Springs, especially on weekends. We'll have people swimming in the springs, kayaking, tubing, unaware of what's around them, including the manatees. And we have to keep an eye on all the people as well as the manatees themselves.
Some of the challenges I've come up with are people want to be too friendly. They want to be too happy. They want to hug the manatees, who wouldn't, but so we have to be a little bit kind of the bad guy sometimes to say, please don't touch the manatees. I mean, I understand they're so cute and adorable.
For me personally, I had one day where there were seven manatees and I was the only one here. I think some of our manatees really like to camp under the stairs or by the stairs, and that's kind of challenging to explain to people. I'm really sorry, but you have to wait.
Yeah, I think on the weekends or holiday weekends, especially when it's really crowded and we end up getting multiple manatees and they're kind of spread up and down the run, it can be a little challenging to try and manage the people. But the truth is that, you know, 99 times out of 100, if you explain to people what we're looking, you know, what kind of reaction we're looking for them and, you know, what the rules are, they're perfectly fine.
There's not a whole lot of people that are not willing to listen, but there are some, and that's a little frustrating. But the coordination of everything, the Blue Springs State Park staff, everybody has been wonderful as far as that goes.
The swimmers and the people who have come to the park to see the manatees, have learned a lot from having the observers here, being able to educate people, being able to help them interact with the manatees safely, and to really enjoy the park better. I think that's been really good this year.
So many people have thanked us for being here to protect the manatees and have asked really interesting questions. A lot of people had never seen a manatee before and didn't know what they were. Other people we've had been very afraid of the manatees, and then when they got some education and saw them actually in the water, they walked away, you know, having a really positive experience about it. So that part I think was really important, to be able to educate people.